Good morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today I'm going to be making a pork loin and coleslaw sandwich. Now I've given you one coleslaw recipe, but I'm going to be giving you another one that's made with sour cream. Now we're going to have to make a spice rub for pork, which I've already done and made this. Now it can be used for beef. And it can also be used for pork. Now I'm gonna go to the page to make to tell you what's in this, because this is what you're gonna have to make. All right, I'll read it slowly so you can sit there and write it all down. You're gonna need a pint jar or something that holds it, because this makes a good cup. You're gonna need 2 tablespoons of paprika. You're going to need 2 tablespoons of chili powder. You need 1 to 2 teaspoons of cayenne pepper. If you don't want it spicy, you can leave this part out. You're going to need 2 tablespoons of garlic powder. You need 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. You can use light or dark, whichever one you wish. You need 1 tablespoon of cumin, 1 tablespoon of dried mustard, 1 teaspoon of sage, 1 teaspoon of oregano, 1/4 cup of salt, and 1 tablespoon of black pepper. Okay, now that's what you need to make the rub for this, and believe you me, it's really good. I'm already thinking about making another kind of sandwich with this. Okay, the coleslaw we'll make after, because this has to sit for at least 4 to 5 hours. Now you're going to need a pork loin fillet. This is what you're going to need. I'm going to do this later. Let me get her scissors and get this going. You're going to rinse this meat off. Okay. And then we're going to dry it. You're going to slice this like this. You're not going the long way, you're going the short way here. 1/4 inch thick is what you're going to cut slices from this, okay? So that's about that thick, okay? I'm going to be bringing things closer for you to see this. Let me turn the light on. Slice this whole thing just like this.
had this to try it to see if the rub was good. It was very, very good. And I am thinking of making a beef sandwich, but I'm not going to tell you which one it is yet, but I am thinking of it. And I just think it would be good. Not a sandwich, is definitely as a steak. It should be very good.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Yes. Yes.
Can I get some water?
Yes, you can.
Small and defrosted, but we'll try. Okay, well, that's the best I can do. Going to pound this, but you do not want this side. You want this side. And you're going to flatten them. When you go to flatten them, you hit down and come off like that. I'll spread it out and I'll show you. See how thin you can get it? That's what you want. Going to continue doing this. See, if you just pound on top, it doesn't work, but as you pound and stretch it, you can get them real thin and cut some of this meat fat off. That's a lot. You don't have to pound hard. They will flatten out easily. Because I'm not hitting hard and it's getting thin. finish pounding these out and get them seasoned, we'll get the coleslaw and the sour cream dressing going. Let me get this cutting board cleaned. Get it out of the way so we're done. What you're going to do next is take that mixture I just gave you. And you're going to pour it on here. Go a little heavy. And you've got to rub it in. Rub it all over them.
you're going to put that aside with a plate on it and let it sit for about 4 hours. So around 12, I'll be cooking these. And it's going on for 8 o'clock. It smells really good. That's the fun of being in the kitchen. You start smelling all these seasonings and everything. Oh, now they say that you can, if you wish, you can leave it for up to 24. Okay, Sandra, I know you're not losing your mind. Okay. Okay, Sandra. Now we'll make the coleslaw. Let me get some dishes. I've got to get to this measuring cup. I gotta move you back just a little because I need my cookbook here so I can read. I can't remember all these recipes I make. It's just too many, way too many. All right, we want 4 cups of shredded green cabbage. Now I'm gonna do this by hand. Now, you can use the shredder. I'm going to use a sharp knife. Just cut it real thin. That's all you have to do. Cups, I think. Is that what I read? Yeah, 4 cups of the green one. Okay.
it all together when I get the other part of it done. All right, now for the red cabbage, they want 2 cups. Just probably just about half of this. Love the color combination. After you sit there and you drain it and you toss the vegetables around, you will notice get more water out. That's what I'm doing right now, tossing to make sure the water doesn't settle in some areas. And see, there it is, more. Now they want two green onions chopped.
Trying to keep my cookbook dry.
Keep it close at hand.
Which is almost an impossible task. But,
whatever. We'll do what we can.
Okay, and they want half of a cup of thinly sliced red onion.
Slices of this one, so it'll sort of flow with the rest. That's a good half. Half of a red onion will give you what you need. This makes a good amount, but you can use this with other meals if you wish. And you know what? I don't think it's going to fit in here either. I'm going to have extra bowls this morning. Okay. Well, I'll get a bigger bowl. I'll be right back. I got bigger ones than this one, too. Here's a bigger one. I'm going to be washing dishes. All right, you're going to put the onions in it. We're going to mix this up and then we're going to get to the sour cream dressing. The reason I cut the red onions in half moon shapes is because they'll be easier to mingle. If you leave the onion whole and slice it, you'll have the rings and you'll have to separate the rings. Whereas this way, because the way the coleslaw, or I should say the cabbages are cut, the onions will mingle quite well with them. Okay.
Let me get the other stuff and I'll be back. Okay, I got the stuff out. We need 2 teaspoons of minced garlic. All right, now they want 1 cup of mayonnaise.
This makes a good amount as well.
They need 1/4 cup of light or dark brown sugar.
So you actually have a choice of which one you want to use. It doesn't seem to matter.
And then they want 1/4 cup of sour cream. Okay. Okay, and we want 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. And a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. And a teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce. Half a teaspoon of Tabasco. I am using Louisiana hot sauce. All right, now we're just going to add salt and pepper, but this is to taste. This one can't really tell you how much to put on or not. Well, I should say put in it. And pepper as well. Now they say you can whisk it all in a together, or you can put it and blend it in a food processor. Then you toss it with the vegetables or the dressing. And you will be adjusting for salt and pepper. That's what I'm doing right now. I need some room here. Clean. Even after you put the whole thing together, taste it again to make sure that you have the whole meal just the way you want for salt and pepper. My hands and mix it. Okay? And then you're going to put this in the refrigerator or the countertop, because it's got to sit as well. This whole dish has to sit. I'm going to leave mine on the counter and just cover it and just let them sit. And I'll be back when this is set for 4 hours, and then we'll put the sandwich together and I'll show you how they want it done and how to do the meat. Listen, that is really good meat. I was surprised how flavorful it was, but I'll show you the next step after all this. But all of this has to sit, so there's like nothing more we can do.
get the meat grill, put it on. We have to get some more stuff. And I will be back in 4 hours and we'll finish this.
Okay, it's been a little over 4 hours. I was out in the yard, so I sort of lost track. You're going to need cast iron, rigid, pan, or a grill outside to do this. I'm setting the heat right now on this thing.
On a minute. I just tasted the salad, see how it was. Okay. The salad is ready. That we're going to be putting on this. Now what we're going to do is get this hot. Now I've already greased the rigid cast iron. I have a grill and one side is rigid. That's what you're going to need to do this, or you're going to have to use a grill outside. They do not want you to use just a regular pan. It's got to be rigid. And what you're going to do, I've oiled it and I'm going to wait for it to get hot. And then we're going to lay these on. And they're only going to cook like 30 seconds. A minute is long, okay? And then we're going to assemble the sandwiches. Now, oh, I forgot to tell you what kind of rolls. Oh my God, I am so sorry. All right, they said you can use egg buns, Kaiser rolls, or any sandwich rolls, okay? And they also state coleslaw and sliced bread and butter pickles or sourdough pickles. Go with this, okay? So that's what we're gonna be doing. So what I did with my rolls is I put some butter on them and I broiled them to toast them. I wanted them crunchy to have it. Okay, because I know the coleslaw is moist. Not yet. So that's why I'm doing it. But when you put the sandwich together, you're going to put the coleslaw on top and on the bottom piece, and the meat is in between it. And you can use pickles, bread and butter pickles, like they said, or you can serve a dill next to it. I'm going to try it, the bread and butter pickles, because the coleslaw is not sour because it's not really pickled. And I think these pickles will go nice with it. Now, for you men, I think you might like it with a light beer. I don't drink, so I'm going to wing it on this because pork is a mild meat. A light beer would go well with it. I'm not overly fond of beer unless I'm cooking with it. Then it makes an excellent roast. And also steaks once they're marinated in it. It's getting there. I got coleslaw between my teeth. So you can be versatile with this. Now this is a dish where most people just slice pork thin from a roast or something and they make a sandwich like this. But this one is very spicy and I like it very, very much. Okay, when it gets hot, I'll be back because I can't talk forever. Okay, it's hot. These are gonna sizzle quite quickly.
So it's just as good as that first time.
Amazing. I love it when I do it on the grill like this, you see the stripes on it, just like when I did the lamb chop. Oh, it's so nice. Wasn't as hot as I thought it would. But it is now. I'll be back. I've been in the yard working and I am so hungry. They are so good. See how thin they are?
They stayed that way.
I know if you do the grill outside, if I cook a little faster than they are inside the house here, I can understand that. How are you going to put the sandwich together? I'm only happy one, the other one's for my son. And he'll have his when he's ready to have his. Oh no. Put them on the bottom so I can put them over. That's how you're doing them. Okay. Now they said you can serve dill pickles or you can put this on it. So I'm going to put these bread and butter pickles on here too. We'll see how this goes. The first time I had it, I didn't. But I said this time I'm going to try it this way. So if you don't like bread and butter pickles, you don't have to put them on, but I'm actually trying it this way. And that is the sandwich. And as you can see, it's a biggie. I am going to go eat lunch because I'm really hungry. You take care and have a wonderful afternoon. Bye-bye.